जत्तर सत्वगुणं सत्सं शांतं भगवत पदम जदाहुर वासुदेवाक्षं चित्तं तन महदात्मकं। बहुनाम जन्मनामन्ते ज्ञानवान मांग प्रबद्धते वासुदेव सर्वमेदं समात्मा सुदेव। दिस स्टेज वासुदेवाक्षं और चित्तं ऑलवेज filled up with Vasudev consciousness, Vasudev Krishna, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva. So, our present position of consciousness is polluted by the three modes of material nature. Satogun, Tamogun and Rajogun. Here, Satogun, the mode of goodness, the Brahminical qualification, Satta, Sama, Dhamma, Saucha, Arjamam, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astikam, Brahma, Karma, Sabhavajam, still it has to be purified. That is called Satchang. Satchang means completely crystal-like, clear. Just like we have got experience, if you go into the mid-ocean, you can see within the water very deep, 20 feet, 30 feet, very clear. Those who have gone through the sea, they have seen very clear. So, the chitta, consciousness, must be clear. Vasudevakham, when one can clearly see Vasudev or the Supreme Personality of God, that is possible. Simply, we have to purify the chitta. That is the process given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How to cleanse the chitta, consciousness. Chitta darpana marjanam. Marjanam means cleansing, polishing. Chitta darpana marjanam. And as soon as the chitta or consciousness is perfectly cleansed, then bhava mahadabhagni nidbhapanam. This bhava mahadabhagni in material existence is compared with blazing forest fire. This is the right comparison, because in the forest nobody goes to set fire, but it takes place. You cannot stop it. And when the forest fire is there, you cannot stop the fire also by your so many counteracting methods, namely getting the fire brigade or buckets of water. That is also not possible. Therefore, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur has compared this material life as blazing forest fire. Samsara dava nalarira loka. This material world is blazing fire. Blazing fire means the forest fire. The forest fire, the example is very typical, because nobody goes to set fire in the forest. Neither it is possible to extinguish the fire in the forest by your so many counteracting methods. This is a very appropriate example. Similarly, in the material existence, nobody wants any trouble. But automatically the trouble comes. Everyone has got experience. Everyone is trying for happiness. Nobody wants for distress, but distress comes here. You cannot stop it. Therefore, those who are advanced in knowledge, they take it for granted that I do not want distress. So, the distress cannot be checked. It comes upon me. Then why shall I try for happiness? It will also come. This is very right conclusion. If without my endeavor, distress comes upon me, so there are two things, distress and happiness, two counterparts. So if distress can come upon me without any endeavor, so the happiness also will come without any endeavor, because this is another counterpart. So why shall I waste my time for this material distress and happiness? That is the injunction of the Shastra. Tasyaiva heta prajateta kovida na labhate jad bhramatamu parjata tallabhate dukha vadarnata sukham kalena sadvatra gavira ranghasa tallabhate dukha vadarnata sukham. Just like distress comes upon me without endeavor, similarly, according to my destiny, destiny means to some extent we suffer and to some extent we enjoy. Actually there is no enjoyment, but we take it for enjoyment. The struggle for existence, the struggle for mitigating suffering, we take it as happiness. Actually there is no happiness in this material world. So anyway, even there is happiness and distress, two relative terms. The one can come without any endeavor, the other also will come without any endeavor. That is a fact. Everyone is trying to become happy according to his own mental concoction or endeavor, but there cannot be any unalloyed happiness. That is the nature of this material. The conclusion should be therefore, we are destined to suffer a certain extent of so-called happiness and certain extent of so-called distress. The distress is also so-called and the happiness is also so-called. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Agama paina anitya tang titikhasa bharat. The happiness and distress which comes and goes, they are anitya, they will not stay. The example is given, śītoṣṇa sukha dukkhada. The winter season and the summer season, they come and go. To somebody, winter season is very nice, and to somebody summer season is very nice. In a western countries they like summer season very much, and in this tropical country they like winter season very much. So actually summer and winter, they are neither distress nor happiness. It is due to the touch of the skin. Matrasparasastu. Matrasparasa means it is due to the touching of the skin. We feel like that. Distress and happiness. Actually, this material world, as certified by Krishna, it is place of distress. There is no happiness. Dukkhalayam asasatam. It has been described in the Bhagavad Gita. This place is place for miserable condition. Dukkha alayam. Alayam, so long you are not annihilated, this place is dukkha alayam. It is miserable condition. We have several times explained. So, we have to purify the consciousness. Then we shall be without any touch of this so-called distance and happiness. That is prescribed here. Satya, jat, jatta, satya gunam, satyam. Here, there is little happiness in the satya-guna. But still that satya-guna can be contaminated by rajaguna and tamaguna. Rajaguna, tamaguna directly distress. And satya-guna, there is little taste of happiness. But that is not complete happiness. The complete happiness is that satya-guna without any touch of rajaguna and tamaguna. That is transcendental. So here it is described that jatta satyagunam, satyagunam does not this satyagunam, rajagun tamagun satyagun, but satcham. Satcham means clean, completely clean, without any tinge of material quality. Jatta satyagunam satcham shantam, shantam. Everyone is seeking peace of mind. People come to spiritual societies or some other way, everyone is searching after some peace. Shantam, shanti. The shanti can be attained when this satya-gunam satcham. When the satya-guna, your status will be on the satya-guna and completely cleans, then you can get shanti. Completely cleans means, that is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, na sochati na kankhati. There is no lamentation and there is no hankering. Then it is shanti. As soon as there is some hankering, you cannot have shanti. That is not possible. And as soon as there is some possession, you cannot be without lamentation. The two things, material, they are ruling over us. We are hankering after something which we do not possess. And what we possess, if it is lost, then you are lamenting. So, shanti means no hankering, no lamenting. That is called shanti. So generally, whatever we may possess, but the hankering is there. That is rajaguna. That is rajaguna. All is hankering. Even up to the stage of so-called perfection, just like the kurmis. Kurmis, they think that perfection of life is very, very high standard of life. Very happy, comfortable. Just like in the Western countries, they think that to have nice roads, nice motor car, and very high skyscraper building, and facilities, a modern comfort, what is called. That is the standard of happiness. And we, Eastern people, we are also imitating them. But actually ask them who possesses all them, that whether you have attained the position of no hankering. No, that is not. The hankering is there. What to think of possessing this material facilities? Even one goes to the heavenly planet. That is also included within the happiness of the karmis. They want happiness in this world as well as after this world. After death also they want to go to the heavenly planet. Sargalo. where the duration of life is many, many thousands of years, and the standard of happiness is very, very high. There, the place is very beautiful, the women are very beautiful, the gardens there, these descriptions are there. Nandan Kanan and Apsaras there are. So this is also another higher standard of life, duration of life. That is the position of the Kurmis. And the Gyanis, they are hankering after to become one with the Supreme. They have experienced that even the standard of material happiness available in the heavenly planet, that also did not give them complete satisfaction. So they aspire to become one with the Supreme. That will give me happiness. I become one with monist. Aham Brahmasmi, I am one with Brahma. So that is also hankering. Mukti. Mukti means liberation from this material unhappiness and come to the spiritual happiness. I am Brahma, I am the same, supreme, thinking concoction like that. So, there is also hankering. And siddhi, yogis, they want many perfection. Anima, lagima, mahima, prapti, siddhi, prakamma, ishita, bhashita. There are eight kinds of yogic siddhi. You can become smaller than the smallest. You can become bigger than the biggest. You can become lighter than the lightest. You can get anything you like immediately. These are some of the yoga siddhis. But this is also hankering. This is also hankering, not shanta. Either kurmi, what to speak of ordinary being, they are simply hankering. Even the so-called perfect kurmis, jnanis, yogis, they are also not shanta. They are hankering. Therefore, Chaitanya Chaitamrita Kar says, bhukti, mukti, siddhi, kami, sakali, asham. Kami, kami means one who desires. So, either you desire comforts of this material body in different standard of life, either in this planet or other planet. Just like they are trying to go to the moon planet for getting higher standard of life. Unfortunately, they are not allowed to stay there, they come back. So, you cannot go in the higher planets in that way. You must be fit for going there. I have several times discussed this matter. Just like American standard of life, it's better than our Indian standard of life. But you cannot enter America, or the Americans cannot enter India without required visa, permission. Similarly, it is not that by your whims you can enter into the higher planetary system. That is not possible. Anyway, these are the field of activities of the kurmis, those who want to become happy by their active execution. I shall be happy in this way, I shall be happy in this way, and make me my plan like that. These are kurmis. They are making simply plans to become happy. But they forget that this is dukkhalayam asasatam. This material world is the place for suffering. They forget that. The scientists and physicists, they are all trying to make this life very comfortable. They are called durasaya. Nati vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu. What is that? Durasaya. They are thinking that by material adjustment we can be happy. Jurasayadi Bahiratha Manina. These karmis, they have got a hope which will never be fulfilled. That is called Durasaya. Asaya means hope. And Durasaya means which will never be successful. So this materialistic person, the karmis, they are trying to be happy by material adjustment. That has been described in the Bhagavad, Durasaya. This kind of hope is never to be fulfilled. It will never be successful. But the karmis, they think they will be successful. They are struggling very hard. The Durasayaji Bahiratman. How? The Bahiratman. Bahi, Bahipragna or external energy, or the material energy. The material energy is called external energy. So that is called Bahi. Bahi means external. Nati vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu durasayaji bahirathamana manina andha jathandhai rupaniyamana ste isatantra hrudami baddha. Because they are thinking tied up by the rules and regulations of the stringent laws of materialism. But they are thinking, they are called karmis. So they cannot be shanta. By material activities you cannot be happy or peaceful. That is not possible. That is being explained here, that jatta sattagunam satsang shantam. Sattagunam, you have to come to the platform of the mode of goodness and still it is to be purified. That is called Vasudeva, platform, or transcendental platform, as it is explained in the Bhagavad. Vasudeva sarvamiti. That time, when you come to that platform, he'll see everything, Godly, Vasudeva, Sarvam, Ishavasam, Idam, Sarvam, everything, God consciousness. That is the platform of Shanti. Beyond that, or before that, you cannot have. Either you become Karmi, or you become Jnani, or you become Yogi. There is no question of Shanti. That is not possible. Therefore, Chaitanya Charitamrita says, the Krishna Bhakta Nishkam, Atayev Shant. A Krishna Bhakta, a devotee of Lord Krishna, a person who is fully Krishna conscious, he has no such desire. He has no such desire. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says in his prayer, na dhanang, na janang, na sundaring, kavitang, ba jagadish, kamay. This is the position of devotee. Generally, karmis, they want something from God. They go to temple, they go to church for begging something. I am distressed, I have no money, kindly give me some money, I am hungry, give me my daily bread, and give me. Something give me. So this, so long we are on the platform of give me, you will never be happy. You'll get it. If you go to God and ask Him, God give me my daily bread, so it is not very difficult for God to give you bread. He is giving bread to everyone, why not to you? He is giving bread to the elephants, He is giving bread to the ants, and what you can eat. That is not very difficult thing. But you should go to God not for begging something, but for giving something. That is Vasudeva's thing. Then you will get something. When you will go to God not for begging material happiness or material liberation, mukti, bhukti, mukti, and not for any jugglery, magic things, just like yogis show some magic. if you want all these things, then you will never get happiness. You will be trouble. Therefore, a devotee, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's standard of devotion, nothing to possess, na dhanang, na janang, na sundaring, kavitang, ba jagadishakang, nothing to possess. Na dhanang, na janang, na sundaring, kavitang, ba jagadishakang, mama janmani, janmani, ishare bhavata bhakti rahitukit. Bhakti. Bhakti means our relationship with God is bhakti, giving service. God is great and we are most insignificant servant of God. Our business is to give service to God. This, when we come to this state, then there will be shanti. Otherwise, there is no possibility of shanti. Bhukti mukti siddhi kami shakuli asanta. Krishna bhakta niskam hatoev shanta. Krishna bhakta has no desire. Why he shall desire? He knows Krishna is there. Whatever I need, he'll supply. And Krishna said, yoga khemam bahamyaham tesham nitya vijuktana. Those who are constantly engaged in my service, I take care how to supply their necessities of life. Then why shall I disbelieve Krishna if I am Krishna conscious? Let me do my duty as servant of Krishna, and whatever necessities are required, he will arrange for that. If you become confident about this thing and completely engage yourself in Krishna consciousness, that is the stage of shanta. That is the stage of shanta. Completely dependent. Avasya rakhive Krishna viśvāsapāra. I surrender to Krishna. Krishna says, sarva-dharmān paritrajñamāmekaṁ saranam. So I give up everything. Even my livelihood, I give up. Krishna says, sarva-dharmān. If I give up everything that I may be doubtful, then how things will go on? How I shall live if I live? No, you shall live. If you believe in Krishna, rakhishyati iti viśvāsa pālanam. Krishna says that I shall give you protection, so why shall I not believe it? This is called surrender. Full surrender. That Krishna, let me engage myself in Krishna's service as Krishna orders. Sarva dhanman paritrajya mamekaṁ saraṇaṁ bhaja. Aham tvā sarva pāpeva mokkhiṣyāmi. If we take this assurance from Krishna,